as a warning, I'm probably going to fail this a lot. That's horrifying. Said.
Thank you.
Fuck!
Oh, fuck! No! Oh my fucking god. No, you're fucking kidding me.
Root Butter, move to Pizza Dog House by the server. Root Butter, center channel.
Every day, baby, I rub the cocoa butter on my face.
Okay. I'm playing East and I was attempting to use keyboard controls. Because I'm gonna like kill my hand using fucking whatever. What's it called? Controller. This boss is fucking cheating though. This boss cheats way too hard. It's time to go back to the controller. Yeah, I have to hold X and B.
Ew.
Terrible. What the fuck am I doing?
Thank you.
Fuck. You didn't even get
to...
You didn't even get to see why it was so ridiculous. Alright, this next one, I'll get to it. What? That's fine. Thank you. we go in the right direction.
on him.
Yeah, I already knew about that. It's terrifying. No! I ran into it while it was still up!
No!
I can't believe that.
Dick Wizard.
shit. You serious? Fucking real. The rock wasn't there. It dealt damage anyways.
This boss is a nog.
So I think I'm still actually making pretty good time on this one compared to the last. Well, not the last boss. The last boss was easy, but the one before that, I think it took me like an hour and a half. Let me get you a time on this one. Alright, I've only been going for an hour and 15 minutes. And that's like all attempts. I think that I'm underleveled by a decent amount.
Dude, it took me like 3 hours to beat the Fury on European Extreme non-lethal, so you're in good shape.
Alright, Mantid's Chamber, my level, 41. Alright, let's return to title. 37! Try leveling up a little bit. Thank you. XP grinding is so fun. XP gain is based on a hit counter. So if I continually do this, I permanently have 1.99 percent experience here. Times 1.99 experience, not 1.99%. Now, I was gonna take a nap today, but it's like 3 o'clock.
Yeah.
Thank you. She loves is good enough.
Do not care enough to get even one more.
Alright, take a bunch. Oh my god, no, I don't have the key. Terrible, I forgot to save after getting the key.
Supra moved to AFK by the server. Supra entered channel.
John Mathis takes like 3,000.
I submitted my Brood War paper.
Really?
No. But I remembered it this morning, I was like, oh yeah.
Yeah, just gotta submit it by tonight. I still haven't started writing my- I'm not even still 100% sure I want to do Dark Souls.
God,
I don't know why
you're worse than me, and I'm not even doing the contest.
I don't know. Barkley was just like I felt strongly about it. No,
just
really.
Just do the Jewish game.
No.
Yeah, no, I know what you mean. I mean, I think I feel strongly about Brood War, but like, I know Brood War has a ton of things wrong with it as well. Like, honestly, most of my love of Brood War storytelling is like nostalgia. It's like all it is. I could make some kind of objective argument like, yes, like, RTS storytelling, like, pre-mission dialogue briefings, and then like, you do like, some shitty scenario that is the epitome of storytelling.
Yeah, I mean, you don't have to jerk it. It's just like, mostly it's just about like describing, just like writing well about the topic. It's not even like this was good or like this is bad. It's just about articulating your ideas well.
I should just submit my Thunderbolt story.
Yes,
that'll be it.
I don't even... Why did I write about Barkley? I don't remember.
Because you fucking loved Barkley, dude? Oh, what did you write?
No, well, yes. Why Barkley? Because I was thinking about doing Final Fantasy X, which is probably, like, the original nostalgia factor for me. To be honest, like, I like Dark Souls story, and I like that you have to kind of hunt for it, but I'm not, like, I don't feel like I can draw a lot of referential ties to other stuff, and I wasn't in love with it either, you know?
Yeah.
I think, like, the ending was kind of cool, but I don't think it, I think I'd rather have an argument with Ben about it than I would. Right.
Yeah. It still gets you to LA.
San Francisco.
Oh. That's not as good, man.
I think it's better. I don't know, I've heard LA is like... concentrated essence of New York City, except on the West Coast. Alright, I'm doing Metal Gear Solid 3 then. It came to me.
Okay.
It fucking came to me in a dream. That's what I'm doing now. This is so okay, it hurts. I wasn't even focusedly thinking about, like, what was the last game I played that made me feel, like, really strongly about the story. Like, what did I really, really like?
Yeah, except I'd actually read your Dark Souls paper and play Metal Gear Solid.
Well, maybe you'll read my Metal Gear Solid paper. The problem with Dark Souls is that it's so, like, so alien. It doesn't really, like... It paints a picture of a fantasy world in a really nice way. It kind of presents, like, mythic lore type stuff the right way, in that it's not changing. It's the perfect static view of that shit. Like, you get the story at the beginning, and by the time you've become involved in the world, everything has long since happened by, like, hundreds of, like, an untold amount of time. Everything is completely deconstructed. Like, you never meet the pygmy. You never get to meet, like, the for reals Sisters of Chaos. You know, like, you don't... Everything has changed so much by then. Like, shit. Even, like, Demon Souls, like, a lot of time passes, but, like... I don't know, I got the feeling, like, even the intro to Demon Souls is like, so all of this awful shit happened, and then this is the aftermath. Whereas Dark Souls, it's like, well, this was so fucking long ago that, like, you doing anything in this world is, like, the biggest shit that's happened in, like, millennia.
Yeah.
That's why the ending is significant, because you're making a pretty definitive stance on whether or not time can progress or not. The time progressing might be, like, a really fucking bad thing, or maybe not. Whereas Metal Gear Solid 3 is totally, like, it's a movie. There's no question about it. The story is a fucking movie, but it's a really, 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 really good adaptation of a movie. Like, it's fucking perfect. Like, don't get me wrong, I like Metal Gear Solids in general, but, like, holy fuck. No one, not even Hideo Kojima, no one has ever made such a good campy action movie as Metal Gear Solid 3. No
one. Fucking god, this mantis.
This fucking mantis. I'm not sure if anyone can either, because, like, they won't have the timing down. Like, Metal Gear Solid 3 had a lot of, like, kind of cheesy shit going on with it, but I don't know. It struck just the right mood. Everything that happened was perfect. And there was enough, like, kind of unpredictable shit that you could look at it and go, like, whoa, holy fuck. Like, why did that happen? That was really big, and then it's like, you know, this had to happen. Had to happen. Another thing is that I don't know if I can like fluff up enough of the tons of threads of story that Dark Souls presents to you, but none of it is, like, actually presented to the player. You have to, like, find all of it. There's just so much
shit
going on.
Well, I mean, actually, you could write a lot about that. So I think that's, like, the attraction, is that you could just, like, write endlessly about, like, the doll that you find in your cell after, like, you fucking... Then you can go to the painted world and shit. Like, that's all really unwelcoming shit that you wouldn't know about. It's inaccessible, but that's the allure.
Well,
like, that's all of Dark Souls. Like, Dark Souls is, like, hipster storytelling. Like, it's, like, hard to get into and, like, really appreciate it to the absolute maximum, and that's why you'd be able to write about it like a fucking faggot endlessly. But I totally get not wanting
to do
it at all. Yeah.
I would. It's just, it really is just the format. Like, they don't, you're not supposed to write endlessly about it. Like, that's kind of something to be avoided for the most part. It's really supposed to just be like a 4-page paper. Because they wanted it to be compatible with a lot of different kinds of stories, like they did, they were just like, alright, give us a rundown, who's the main characters, you know, highlight from the story, pros, cons, because, you know, they get that some stories are like just too long to be put on a 4-page paper like that. And you're not supposed to rehash the whole story, like, in detail. That's right. Not the point. Because the judges aren't going to play the game. They're not going to, like,
they should step it up.
They're not going to be like, oh man, we have to shoot down this kid's claims if they're not right. They're not going to do that. So,
it's just write well about what you think is cool.
Exactly.
But don't bore them.
Right.
Because to talk about Dark Souls, you'd have to, like, actually explain it. I don't think you could really. Like, it's so esoteric that it's kind of like,
Yeah. Like, not to mention, my Barclay paper, like, pretty much the takeaway from that was that, like, it might have been, like, super tropey, but it was still really enjoyable. Like, not even only for the jokes. Because if it had just been jokes without any of that trope bullshit for you to laugh at, I don't think it would have been a successful piece. Same shit with Metal Gear Solid 3, exactly. Like, everything just fits into place so well. Like, it's a fucking James Bond film, but it's, like, not. Which is great.
Yeah.
That's why I have to watch all the James Bond films right now. In preparation.
Dude.
I've also played the shit out of the game, which helps.
Dude. The end of Knife Man drops so hard.
Yeah. Yeah, I was listening to No One on Loop yesterday before I decided that I was gonna give up on life. I just went to sleep.
I also listened to Can't Maintain, and some of People Who Can Eat People are the luckiest people.
Well, I have to take a shower, but first I have to watch Devin beat his boss.
I don't know.
So it better be this time, Devin.
Is he streaming?
Yeah, he is. I give you a link.
Contents may be inappropriate.